that seen me on cross ever. You got it right. Go just like that. Got you any mountain? Soul. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You may be seated. We thank God for the mighty word. Amen. Of faith in our soul. One of the hardest things, one of the hardest things I'm learning, one of the hardest things is the word of God. Is the word of God. Is the word of God. The prophetic word of God is one of the hardest things. And that's why if you look in Revelation chapter 18, And a fifth verse is, you see that the main problem of Babylon was the apostles and the prophets. Looking at your seat, that was their problem. So they did everything against them. You know, over the years, the Lord has spoken so many things. So many things. And even as they are spoken, some many years ago, some relatively recently, some recently, is to see them coming to pass. And folks don't even get it when they come to pass. Even when they come to pass, folks don't get it. Over the years, the Lord has always warned that the immigration condition of the earth was going to change. We warned of it like from 15 years ago, 20 years ago. It's going to change. And the warning came, whatever you have to do, make a change. No matter what hang up you have personally. Because some folks got hang up and say, okay, I'm from this country. I'm a citizen of a country. I will never change. I'm not going to become a citizen of this country for some reason. But they despise the prophetic. It never work. Can I tell you something? It's just great people do these things. Good people. Remember, Moses was rebuking the people against God. He was a great man, an awesome man, and he was speaking against the people for their behavior towards God. And in the midst of him rebuking them for God, he did not, actually, I want to use the exact word the Bible used. He did not entreat the Lord. Are you getting me? Watch me now. This is this mighty man. The Bible says he's the meekest ever on the earth. And while he rebuking the people, as God said, in the midst of it, he just did not entreat the Lord. And had to pay a high price for it. A lot of high price is being paid because folks, so just don't believe the word of God. You just can't say what you want to say. You know, we were advising some of the ministers when they're baptizing, when they're receiving members, when they're receiving, when they're doing marriages, when they're doing dedication, that there's a certain way you invoke God because you're not doing your thing, because you're just there, and there's a certain way, and they just go halfway, three-quarter way. You know, I don't know if you get done. When they baptize you, I don't know if you get done. Are you with me? Because God has a certain way to invoke. Come on. And even though I am a man here and I'm a minister and I am a bishop, not because I'm a bishop, I must invoke like all God said I should invoke. Come on. And I being a bishop mean nothing unless I invoke as God said invoke. Glory to God. And some of you here and some of you watching, you're having trouble right now. Because even some of you with your green card in your country, for you to renew it, you're going to have to take this stuff. And you're getting warned. Mighty people, holy people, anointed people, and you're being warned. But because of your own hang-ups, you never come to your leader and say, well, you know, there's a situation holding them back. Something happened, you know, 25 years ago, but you just despise it. I know you can't do nothing. You can't do nothing. Some of you have to move to the next level. You're going to have to take the thing. If I see you at that level, I know you're backslide. I'm telling you, it's not easy. Guys, pure good people. It's pure Moses-like people slipping up now. Are you there? Immigration. So much people from other country. I know they can't come. By November 8th, you can't step here without a backslide. What nobody want to say. I'm saying it like it is. You can't step here after a certain date in a couple of weeks without a bow to the beast. You think the bow to the beast is some plaything? Some people getting mad with the bishop. See, they're getting mad. Ever since they start the vax in this country and across the world, and they lead a whole line concerning those who did on that day, oh my, I've never seen such resentment. I've never seen such change in behavior. I've never seen it. I'm telling you. People, and yet still, the revelation was just to help people. I've never seen it. Some of the best people, since that time, they are different. They change. I'm telling you. Not because I don't talk about it. I look over it and just fast and praise. Bad! The resentment. I'm sitting in the church and somebody just bought a house. I'm going to tell you. Just bought a house and they sit about the third bench on the back. And we are saying, it's time to leave. Leaving is a weapon. And that person with their eyes just rolling like a devil towards me. Hear him again. I'm going to tell him what she said in the spirit. Hear him again. I just bought my house. And he want me to leave my house. Don't you hear somebody? Glory to God. When we came to Florida and begin to do the work of God, we couldn't even fly by plane. We had to drive. Are you there, somebody? And then we came. That's why when we hear over the news that Florida was the worst in infection, you're listening, of this disease. We hear Florida was the worst. Family members, everybody said, don't go. Are you there, somebody? But we're sent by God. Come on. Stop the plane, I'm leaving. Stop the plane, I'm leaving. Stop the plane, I'm leaving. To the promised land I go. I know it now. And I won't return. Shut up. And they said, don't go. Some relatives tried to shudder their own relatives when they heard they were coming. Said, don't go, don't go. It's burning up down here. And today we're seeing the news. We're seeing the news. My God of mercy. We see in the news. We have Florida as the lowest infection in the whole country. Are you sitting on are you sitting on the seat? Rakata shakata. Shakata sakata. Rakata kata. Rakashaka baba. Sit down. This was published by the anti-church news. Huh? Anti-Christ news. Are you there? The beast news. And for them to publish it, you must know they can't do better. You must know that their stink is gone so bad, they got to say something. But here's the other part of it. It is an expression of the fulfillment of the word of God. Not only in speech, but in instruction. Are you there? What are you doing when you have been told it's time to leave? There is a family in what I call a beast land. A beast land is just somewhere which is heavily under the Antichrist attack, with mandates and people losing their livelihood and people can't go to school and can't go to the gym and can't eat. There's a family, I'm going to tell you. You got to leave right away. I'm telling you. There's a family. You got to leave right away. This beast thing has many sides to it. Let me tell you about five sides to it. If we don't get this thing, the enemy want to take your health, your wealth, your mind, and your life. And one more, forget that. That's what they want. That's what the enemy want to take. It's not just the simple things, you know. country, being in this land, is not a thing to take lightly. Some of you are on the edge. Some of you begin to behave contrary that you don't even realize what happened. The contrariness I've seen begin to arise in this land. There are some folks need to run. You're not going to lose your money. You're not going to lose your health. But you're going to lose your conviction. Your conviction is going to change. You're going to begin to preach strange. And you don't know what will come upon you. Because you should have left. And you need to move quickly. There's even a family, and here's how it happened. There's even a family, and God spoke to this family and said, there's something that you're going to do. There's a certain event you want to do, but you got to omit certain persons. And by the power of God, by the prophetic counsel of God that was given to you, and you decide to resist it, I don't care. It's going to be like how I want it to be. And even though, since this thing happened, since this thing came upon the earth, you have seen that counsel of omission. Bow! You're still resisting. It's not going to work. A visionary has nothing to do with the words. Sometimes he's shaking when he get it. Sometimes he just shut up because he just can't speak it. Are you there? You have something to play with. Listen, I told you, don't go to that place with her. That's not because she's the sweetest lady in the world. But I'm just giving an example. Don't go to that place with her. So I don't care. I like her. She's my friend. I'm going to go with her. Maybe. You didn't hear from God. Maybe you don't like her. You know. 1 year later, she backslide. Doesn't that vindicate the prophecy? Doesn't that say, well, Bishop must have been right? But all when she backslide, you're still going with her. You're still going. Listen, you can drop dead. Can I talk to you really? I say you can drop dead. Folks don't understand the prophetic word of God. God prophetic word, the only thing about it that is going to happen.
Come on.
Oh, God have mercy. That's the only one. It's going to happen. You could twirl, you could get upset, you could hiss your teeth, you could say, hear him again. You could say all of that. Is that it's going to happen. And the only escape is to run out. Run out. Don't be a victim. Come on, somebody. You could just buy a house yesterday. And God said, go, go. Let me tell you something. God gave a revelation. And God says the mandates of the beast will fail. And here's what some people do. Because they hear the mandates will fail and they had planned to leave this land, they stay. That means that they want to be kicked out. Are you there? They want to get hurt. They are waiting to be damaged. They are waiting to be bruised. But God gave the revelation, so even when they give you the religious exemption, you say, I'm going because I am free.
Yes.
When you stay just because they give you an exemption, then you're working off them. You're working off their allowance, their door. But when you look at them and say, even though I can go back, I am leaving, I am going. Because I'm led by God. Can I tell us I'm heavy? You mean if you run out and let me speak to the bench and then they come back? Some people don't know that even when they're assigned because the Holy Ghost knows they won't leave. So they're assigned to stay. Come on, I think if you like it. I don't want my things happen. Then I'm the one I have to give account to God. Some folks are assigned because they're not going to leave. No matter what, they're not going to leave. So what we're gonna do? Lead them on a side? Since they're gonna stay, do this and do that and do that. I told you what have you and come back in. So don't take assignment and quote an assignment that means I must stay. Listen, you could be called to be the deputy bishop of Beastland. And God move on you to move. Move. Shiki basakata la yakata.
Amen.
Rakata sakata la. Glory to God. Are you in somebody? I said some folks need to move.
Amen.
Shibakata sa. Shibakata da bakata sa. Shakababa. You don't know that the counsel you get, you don't know the counsel you get is prophetic. Come on. You don't know the counsel you get is prophetic. All some folks told to marry early. And I hear them, no, I'm going to wait till I finish college. Oh, go. I'll even go get the college wife for you. I know, I'm telling you, you can't anger God. I know you can't anger God. When you're ready 4 years' time, tell me and I'll even go get one for you. But prophetically, you'll be a failure. I mean, have that wife for 6 months. Oh, some of you are hanging around, looking around, past 20. Eh? And God give revelation. Listen, if 4 people write in here, I tell them who they're going to marry to without giving their name.
Come on, preacher.
I could tell them to stand up.
Come on, preacher.
Write in here now. No. You want me to try?
Come on,
glory to God. Glory to God. Young lady, stand up at the back. Don't put no camera on her. Stand up at the back. What did I tell you in Jamaica at the convention at the back of the church? Did I tell your husband he'll be a pastor? Is he in church tonight?
Is he a pastor?
Sit down. Okay, you got to be careful. It's something you can't get around. You have to pay attention to. Don't look at who. Run from stuff. Don't look at circumstance. Listen. God can tell you. I hereby call you to go to Miami as of tomorrow. Amen. Amen. That's his spirit. But watch me now. Is God set to go? Is God set to go? Listen to me, God. But before tomorrow, God return. God return. God return. You have to be careful. God return tonight. And is he tell you go tomorrow? You're not responsible once he return. And what he didn't know was so perfect. For the moment he say go, he say I'm ready. I can say don't worry, there's a lamb caught in the thicket. And some people don't give God no chance for a lamb to be caught in the thicket. What was the preacher praying about? Preaching about today, about faith in God. Because Abraham had faith in God. That God could raise up his son from the dead. He went forth and God could cause a lamb to be caught in the thicket. How many of you ever obey God so a lamb of to be caught in the thicket? None of you. It only have to be convenient. The Lord said, one person who have bowed, who you believe in, is about to bow again. And you thought they would never bow again. You believe in them. You've been defending them. Come on, somebody. And the Lord said, they are bowed about. Stand up, somebody. Don't fight the prophet, no matter who you are. Don't fight the prophet. Listen. I'll say one more thing. If you have been used prophetically in the church, and you bow now, I'm not still in the plane. You're not going to make it. I'm not still in the plane. You're not going to make it. Prophetically. And even if you made a mistake and went that way before, listen to me well. Be careful of going to the pro-vax churches. Today there are 2 kind of churches, anti-vax and pro-vax. And even if you went and got vaxxed, brother, don't run to the pro-vax church. The pro-vax church is pro-vax because they struggle with the word of God. They can't hold. So if you made a mistake, stay with those who show you you're wrong. Stay with those who give you a chance to change your life. Stay with those who are willing to raise up Peter into a bishop. Stay with those who was willing to raise up David, who missed his way, to become a man after God's own heart. Let us pray. One more thing. There are some pastors that need prayer. If you never want prayer as a pastor, it ain't going to be good. There are going to be things come up. Let me tell you. If you reach a stage where you don't want prayer, it's not going to be good. Today in class, we look for as many things we could find. We could find when a pastor needs prayer. Or when a spiritual leader needs prayer. We got 31, but we went to 33 after that. When a spiritual leader needs prayer, the biggest deception is when we think we don't need prayer. Or we don't want prayer because we struggle with the line that particular leader hold, the stand they take. But the Lord says there are some ministers that need prayer. And if they don't get prayer, it's not going to be good. It's not going to be good. I remember there was a situation before us as this thing came on the earth. This wicked thing, this sub-dispensation change came. It was so tough as things begin to change and the best begin to bow down. And I remember there was a moment when I had to make a decision. Yes, I had to make a decision because of what's coming, because most folks don't see what's coming. All we can deal with is what we see yesterday and what's before us. And as I could see ahead what's coming, I had to make a tough decision. And I know what would have happened if it was made. There are some people, sorry to be going over like this and so disorganized. There are some people, the devil want to destroy you. The devil want to break you. Yes, the devil want to break. And is that the way that you think? But he's targeted. Some of you are great people, already used by God. And God says, make sure that you take every opportunity to be delivered. All if you don't need it. Sorry to be so long with you. When I was growing up, one of the things that caught my attention, my mother was just a little lady, preacher lady, preaching the town, She was not a reverend, she was not a pastor. She was not even an official evangelist. She was just like a hard prayer warrior. And she'd preach. But I remember as a little boy, listen to me good. As a little boy, every day, two or three cars would drive up to her house and park. And then I would hear them talking on the veranda. You can't hear. They were pastors and bishops and mighty men who came to my mother and said, I need prayer. There are too many unprayed leaders. They came and we could never hear nothing. All we hear, bind up and cast out devil and the blood is against you. Shibaba. And those ministers would get up and go. They had stuff they couldn't handle. And they knew there was a little lady. She was not a bishop nor a reverend. But then you then needed prayer. A prayer mama could pray for them. And every one of those ministers today are up to some of our past by now. Mighty men of God. And you will never hear one thing from her about what went on. Well, today, in the same way, there are some ministers that need prayer. Even though you're mighty, is prayer going to help you? We pray, God deliver. We pray, God stop the war. We pray, God, thank you. God deliver, thank you. God. Any minister need prayer. Okay. We pray, God. We pray, God, stop the war.